नमस्कार, मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर अशोक दौलतराव भागवत. आय एम फ्रॉम ज्ञानश्री इन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ इंजिनिअरिंग अँड टेक्नॉलॉजी, डिपार्टमेंट जनरल सायन्स अँड ह्युमॅनिटीज. आय एम टीचिंग द सब्जेक्ट इंजिनिअरिंग फिजिक्स. ॲज अ पार्ट ऑफ इंटरनॅशनल FDP ऑन एनवायरमेंट अँड सस्टेनेबिलिटी, आय एम मेकिंग दिस व्हिडिओ. इन दिस व्हिडिओ आय ऑलरेडी प्रिपेर्ड टू व्हिडिओज. The YouTube links are shared here. In the video 1, I have used the physics principles to study the environment and sustainability. In every year, we use the physics principles to study the processes occurring in the nature. So I have discussed these points in the video number 1. And in week number 2 video, the link is here, and the content of that video are recycling of lithium-ion batteries, the reuse and the recycling process of the lithium-ion batteries are discussed in that videos. Now the topic of today's videos is the energy environment and effect of manufacturing process of the lithium-ion batteries. Before that, I will discuss the outcome of the videos of week number 1 and week number 2. We are able to understand the environment and sustainability by studying the physics principle and use of it to develop the sustainable mechanisms. Outcome number 2, understanding of the lithium-ion batteries recycling process and its reuse for sustainability. Outcome number 3, the development of sustainable mechanisms to save the valuable metals used in manufacturing of these lithium-ion batteries and the recycling processes. Okay. So in this video we will discuss the energy environment economy and the effect of manufacturing of lithium-ion batteries with the greenhouse emissions. The topics discussed here are standards of the battery, carbon emission in manufacturing the lithium-ion batteries, other greenhouse gas emissions, LCA and sustainability standards and solution of the lithium-ion batteries. The general battery standards are shown in this table. We can see here the standard number and the title of that standard number. Here we can see the ISO 9001 and 2000, also the ISO 14000, a series of environmental management system standards created by ISO. So these standards are the for production of the battery, use of battery and the safety of battery and their recycling, the products, waste management are discussed with these standards. The specific standards of the lithium ion battery, these are the standard numbers and these are the titles of these standards. So this is related with the lithium-ion battery standards. Now we'll discuss the carbon emission in the manufacturing of lithium-ion batteries and its carbon footprint. The 3E process. In 3E process, the manufacturing of any lithium-ion battery, we required energy, environmental materials, raw materials, and economy. So first, energy is consumption through the electricity for production, then environment, in that atmospheric environment the NMP emissions takes place, then water environment, COD emission and NH3N emission in the production process takes place, then solid waste, that is domestic waste and ordinary industry waste, also the hazardous waste, and the economy. fixed capital, the unit of investment for the production of the lithium ion batteries, and the variable cost which is required for the material, raw material. Then we will discuss the carbon emission in manufacturing the lithium ion batteries and its carbon footprint. In this process of manufacturing, the raw materials are used. To purify these raw materials, energy is required, the material production for the lithium ion batteries, so that the pollutant emissions and greenhouse emission takes place. Also, these raw materials used for the production of lithium ion batteries or the manufacturing of lithium ion batteries, also the energy is required and some byproducts are there. Also, the pollutant emission with the greenhouse gas emission takes place. Now, how much amount of the emissions are takes place are assessed by the life cycle assessment given by the ISO standards of LIB products and its carbon footprint, means equivalent carbon emission takes place, CO2 emission takes place. So LCA is a kind of typical tool that can analyze the characterize the product, which can be used to research the whole life cycle process, including raw materials, production, manufacturing, use and final deposition. The International Organization for Standardizations, ISO, state that LCA can be divided into four phases: goal and scope definition, inventory analysis, impact assessment and interpretation. As a bottom-up calculation method, LCA has been widely used in microanalysis. With a wide use of LCA, a lot of softwares, for example SimaPro, Umbentro, with the various database and calculation methods is developed around the world. LCA was used to analyze the environmental impacts of different LIB products. The functional unit of LCA is 1 gigawatt hour battery production, and CF, that is carbon footprint, is selected as the impact indicator. CF, carbon footprint, is a kind of measurement of a carbon emission and has been recognized by many international communities, which is mainly used for the assessment of environmental impacts caused by the human activities. We consider the two cases. Basically, the high amount of battery production takes place in China's. In China, the two case studies are there. According to that case study, the total carbon footprint for raw material production in two case studies is 1599.08 and 894.57 kg CO2 equivalent of case 1 and case 2 respectively for the production of 1 gigawatt hour batteries. The carbon footprint of lithium compound is extremely high compared to the other materials for above two cases batteries, which is 785.97 for this case and 715.45 kg CO2 equivalent for the second case. Due to the scarcity of lithium as a resource, the equitization of it requires greatly complicated processes with lot of greenhouse gas emissions. The CFS, carbon footprints of the separator and graphite, is also higher than other materials because of high consumption in actual productions. We can see this in this graph. The NMP emissions, this is the carbon footprint. Lithium ion phosphate, this is carbon footprint kg CO2 equivalent, 780.97 for case 1. For case 2, 715.45. For case 1, graphite emission 163.07. For case 2, it is 79. In this way, the copper, foil, aluminium, nickel strip, and separator. So this is the LPF, is a battery case 1, and same is battery case 2. These case studies are performed in the China. Material used for the battery production and their cost. Some sustainability standards of LIBs. These are the materials used to production of the batteries and their percentage and cost per ton. You can see here in this table, this is the economical rate which is required for the production of the batteries. Sustainability standards and solutions for the LIBs. Some of the solutions and standards are here. Lithium ion batteries pose some challenges for large scale recycling, but they also present the sustainable opportunities. Recycling is a relatively well developed for the components of the conventional vehicles. For example, about 99% of lead acid batteries are recycled from the vehicles in the United States and other countries. Now China and other countries also recycle the lithium ion batteries nowadays, but the rate is 50% only. The reuse and green decarbonization of LIBs is one of the method through which we can increase the reuse of the batteries. Here are some developments and the percentage emission of the CO2 in manufacturing processes. Okay, large electric vehicles, this is the range, 18%. Battery, if this battery is used for second time, the manufacturing process is nil, and this CO2 percentage is in a minus 22%. Battery recycling, minus 7% and 17%, here minus 4%. Projected grid decarbonization, minus 17%, minus 27%. Greater battery energy density, minus 10% to 15%, 6%. Okay, so this one is a sustainable development. The one of the solution is that grid decarbonization offers a significant opportunity to reduce the impact of battery manufacturing. The emission from the battery manufacturing are likely to decline significantly in the coming decades, especially with the use of cleaner electricity throughout the production cycle. A 30% decrease in the grid carbon intensity would reduce the emission from the battery production chain by about 17%. In addition to even greater saving in the use of recycled materials and battery chemistries with the lower carbon intensity could also reduce the emission in the manufacturing phase. Thank you.